Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
The temperament of it, very stable, very sweet, very loving dogs, which is something I enjoyed. I was able to bond very quickly, but at the same point, very protective of its property, of its people. And once it gets that bond with you, you know, that connection, it's there, and it would do anything for you, really. Hi, my name is Darren. I run and own Dax American Bulldogs out in Apple Valley, California. Well, I started with a couple different breeds, but for me, it was always kind of, I wanted something a little different, something a little more, something I could connect to, something that was naturally protective. Yeah, well, I've had a couple encounters now with people actually out here, even though I'm farther away, which is kind of one of those things. Like, if you're out here, you're out for a reason, you know. There's no reason to be going past my property at all. There's nothing past me but plain empty desert. So once you're out here, you're looking to do something bad. So yeah, I have been out here before at 4 a.m., 12 a.m., because I hear a dog go off, and I'm going, that's not a bark that tells me, oh, just a cat walking by or a squirrel. There's something wrong bark, and I've had to come running out here, and unfortunately, I have found people out here. but I'd say even scarier than that, we've had time sitting here on the property where we're all relaxing, sharing dinner, having a drink, and I got one of my big dogs, Hale, 120 pounds, just rolling around the property, exploring like he loves to do. And I think it was about maybe 10 p.m. I look behind me, I see a light kind of flash out here, and it kind of hits this white figure, and I think, oh, there's my dog. And then all of a sudden, I see my dog come running behind it, and I'm going, that's my dog, what is that? And I realize it's a mountain lion crossing my driveway right here, and he was chasing right after it, thankfully. So thankfully, he was big enough to, I guess, scare that guy right off the property. No encounter, because I'd be really afraid for my dog's health and well-being if it did catch up to a mountain lion, just one dog alone. But yeah, we've had quite a few things. Coyotes, there's wild packs of dogs that live out here. So there's a lot of things that could go wrong, and that my dogs do help out here on the property. Just protecting me, protecting the chickens, the quail, the barn cat that rolls around. So, I mean, they are very useful, not only as a watchdog, but a guard dog, because there is a little difference there. A watchdog's going to bark and alert you, and a guard dog's going to hold its ground at the fence and say, if you come in, you're going to get bit, you know? And when it comes down to it, most of these dogs here will bite if you push them hard enough. Well, yeah, starting this American Bulldog kennel, it definitely, you know, it was an extension of my love for animals, love for dogs, but it also is just something I grew up with. My dad actually ran a full kennel of Labrador Retrievers, beautiful, great dogs. I absolutely loved growing up with them. A lot of fun. We used to work them, scent, dummy work, kind of all of it. They were great retrievers. I really enjoy working with them, doing the field work and everything. Wasn't really my cup of tea, you know, when I got older. I just loved more that appearance of strength and power, and, you know, just the shorter coats were kind of a thing for me, and the colors a little flashy. So getting out of the gun dog world and transitioning, I didn't even go to the American Bulldog right away. I actually got a blue nose pit first and had him for a while. And then I moved to Staffordshire Bull Terriers, which I fell in love with that breed. They're awesome, awesome dogs. A little high strung, a little hard to keep sometimes, you know, if you're not prepared for it. As much as I love them, I didn't really breed them or anything. I just had them as pets, and awesome dogs to take hunting as well. That ratting aspect that they bring to the table as terriers, you let them out in the field out here in the desert, they will bring you back a cottontail, they'll bring back a squirrel, they'll bring you back a field mouse or a kangaroo rat, you know. So they were a lot of fun to have, but they didn't really bring to the table everything I was looking for. I wanted more size, I wanted that appearance, I wanted that shock and awe. When I'm walking down the street, someone looks over, they go, whoa, what is that, man? That thing is impressive looking. And that's kind of what led me to the American Bulldogs, you know, was that aspect, the appearance, and then their temperament, the stability on top of it, that just sealed the deal for me. I fell in love with the breed. So there's two different types of American Bulldogs. We got the classic type, which are also called the Johnson or the Bully. And then we got the standard type, also called Scott or performance type. And there's big differences between them, and there's a lot of similarities between them. The Bully type, of course, as the name implies, it's a bullier dog in appearance. A little thicker size, thicker bone, thicker muscle. It's gonna have a wider set frame and structure to it. It's gonna have that shorter muzzle, bullier face, more wrinkles to it, and it's gonna have thicker skin as well. The Scott performance appearance wise is gonna be a little bit narrower, tighter skin, longer muzzle, not too many wrinkles. They might have a little loose jowl set like the Bullies, but they all portray things kind of the same. If you look close enough, they have that wide set muzzle to them. A nice blocky, wide squared up muzzle, nice wide set nose, nares. And if you really look at their structure, they got that medium size back to them, good height. You know, they're around the same. There's just those little differences here and there, appearance wise. And temperament wise, I would say this is where things kind of come into play with even people looking to purchase or get into the American Bulldogs, you know. If you're looking for a dog that's gonna chill out, hang out with you all day, and then it's gonna have that explosive energy, boom, to get up and go do something or work or guard your house, the bullier type's probably gonna be what you're leaning towards. Now, if you want a lighter frame dog where you're gonna go, hey, I'm gonna go hike this mountain back here, and then when we get home, we're gonna do some protection sports, you know, you might not want a bully. It's gonna go, hey, I'm tired, man. I'm gonna go sit back on the sidelines for a minute. Whereas the performance type, they're gonna be right there with you. They're gonna be ready to work and ready to go. So that kind of brings into play also with the two types being hybrid types, which you can get a vast array of. You know, you get a bullier hybrid or a more standard hybrid, which is pretty cool. You know, you're able to work a purebred dog with so many different sides and bring so much versatility to the table. And that's kind of what I'm honestly working with here, is the in-between, the bully appearance to them, the size, the structure, the height with the standards coming in, the legs with the standards, you know, a little higher, and that drive, that push. You know, I love to see my dogs work, run around. It's incredible to see a big muscular animal, but it's not impressive to see a big muscular animal that can't move. Now, seeing one that's up, running a yard, moving, coming at you, you're gonna go, wow, this thing is impressive. And that's kind of what my goal is, what I'm looking for in these dogs. So the traditional work of the American Bulldog would of course be catch dog work, companion work, farm dog work. In the aspect of catch dog, I would say it's leaned more towards cattle back in the day. I know they said butchers would generally own these dogs, use them to go, you know, hold down a bull if needed. And also hog dog work, which we see today, tons of American Bulldogs being used as hog dogs, as catch dogs for hogs. And they honestly excel at it very well. Another thing to look at is the farm dog aspect. Having dogs around chickens or fowl, you know, these dogs do good. They're not high prey drive, I'm gonna kill everything on sight. They're just gonna kind of look at it and go, oh, this is part of my family, let me protect it. So they're a very versatile dog, especially for utility work. You know, no matter what you have, if you're on a farm, it's going to be one of the best dogs you can have. You know, traditionally speaking, I guess it would probably be one of the most all-around used dogs. No matter what you're looking for, if you need to pull a cart, it'll pull a cart for you. You need to guard your house, it'll guard, you know. My vision and what I'm working towards is somewhere really close to Killian. I feel like he's a great base for the direction I'm going. Because I, like you said, it's that working aspect that these dogs were originally bred for. You know, these are working dogs. They weren't originally brought to show rings and said, oh, what's an American Bulldog? What's an American Bulldog? It was more of a, what's a versatile working dog? And of course, I like that aspect. I love the work. I love the drive of these dogs. I love the power. I love the explosiveness of them. But it's that appearance too that really brings me to them. So getting that right mix of having this impressive bully dog with great legs under it, great movement, a stable working temperament, which is very, very key for these dogs, just to be able to do anything, sit with a kid, take out hunting, you know, pull, weight pull, anything that you need to do, protect your property. That's something I'm really working towards currently, is having these dogs and their temperament and their workability. I want to really bring that to the front on my bullier kind of hybrid style dog, just to keep that overall appearance that I enjoy with having the temperament on top of it. So a lot of American Bulldogs, the bully type today, they're going a lot shorter and a lot wider set in their stature and in their build. As much as I love the bully appearance of them, I don't really want these shorter, wider dogs that kind of more resemble an old English Bulldog. I'm hoping to keep the height on them, keep a clean gait, keep clean movement. I want to see good reach when my dogs are moving. Their front end, I want to see good reach to them, as well as their rear. I want to see a lot of drive, a lot of push, a lot of power coming from them, as they should be. You don't really want the whole wide set throwing elbows left and right while they're moving. You want that clean, effortless gait so that they're able to go and do stuff with you, no matter what you want to do. You know, you don't want a dog that's having trouble and having to put effort into moving. You want it to effortlessly glide right there next to you. If you want to go take a hike or a jog or a run and come back and play some ball, that's a key factor just for, honestly, the dog and how high drive these dogs are too. You got an extremely high drive dog and it's got small legs or legs that are offset too far, that's a lot of effort it has to put into just moving. Same thing kind of goes with the breathing aspect of it, of course. You know, you got a dog that's high strung, ready to work, really explosive, but it can't breathe. I mean, what's the point? You know, you got to set your dogs up right, and these dogs having good leg under them is something really important that I honestly hope more breeders kind of look into as far as the bully aspect of it. The standards, of course, have it. They got great legs under them. But to get those legs under a bully American Bulldog, that's when you're going to get these dogs that perform and move and look just beautiful. The bully American Bulldog does have a slight roach back. Whether that's a good thing or a bad thing, people go back and forth on it. I've heard, you know, it's there for a reason. I hear other people say, no, clean it up. to me, I do like a cleaner top line. That is just my preference. I do. I think a little cleaner top line looks nice. It gives the appearance of the rear being either completely level or a little lower, which again, aesthetically is nice. But then again, you're gonna have people coming back saying, no, the bully standard has roach back in there for a reason. So it's kind of one of those here and there things. And if you look at my yard, you look at a dog like Kimber, you're gonna see a slighter roach back to her. And then you look at a dog like Gamora at only 9 months, and that's a clean top line. So it's not something I'm too worried about, the roach back, even though I do prefer that cleaner style of top line to them for sure. Kimber, if I'm looking at any of the muzzles on my yard, Kimber has that perfect muzzle for what I'm looking for. It's not smashed. It's also not extremely long. It's right there in that mid-range area. And you can tell by her performance, that's kind of that sweet spot right there. She's got a nice wide set, muzzle squared, blocky. Right when you look at it, you notice that's a big square and it's sticking out just enough, a little bit more than most bullies, a little less than most standards. And you're also gonna notice a wide set nose with big open nares and a clean breathing dog. You know, that's why I'm using her as kind of my base when it comes to this, is to get that drive, that temperament, and really that muzzle. I mean, that muzzle's a key thing for these American Bulldogs. Going too short, you're gonna get too much underbite to them too. You wanna kind of clean that up. You won't want dogs that have all their bottom teeth sticking out of their mouth all the time. So keeping that sweet spot in muzzle is right where I want to be. And I'd say, honestly, again, right around Kimber size is where I'd want to stay with that. No, I honestly do have plans to keep going, and I do have a couple of breedings lined up in the future already. And I'm very happy with how far my dogs have come. I had a lot of small dogs, you know, they weren't really doing it for me, and they would throw very scattered. I'd throw one dog 65 pounds, another dog 135 pounds, you know, it's like, where's the consistency here? Now my dogs are a lot more dialed in. I'm throwing a good range, you know, it's a lot tighter. All the dogs are coming out very consistent. I'm not getting a long nose and a short nose. So keeping up with that and trying to keep that in my program in these next 5 to 10 years, I'm having to be very, very selective with these American Bulldogs. Even though there's a vast array, it's a vast array of type. Not only is that type, but it's inconsistent type. Unless you find a good breeder that has been breeding for a type for generations already. So one thing I am trying to add is this working ability to my dogs. So coming into it, kind of looking for more of a hybrid standard type to slowly add for work, for these longer legs I was talking about. Also, I'm trying to add a little more stifle angle to my dogs just to give their rear end a little more power and a little more drive as they're moving. So I'm hoping to end somewhere, like I said, around Killian. I want to tweak a couple things. I still want a little more height to him. I still want a little more muzzle to him. A little bit bigger head would also be nice. He's got a great rear. His rear is very, very straight, very big, very powerful. That's just another thing. I just want a little more angle. Just a little more angle, I'd be so happy with him, even though he has great angles already. So in these next 5 to 10 years, I'm looking to really expand. And now that I've gotten enough information on the breed and to be able to look at a dog and evaluate it, and then also evaluate the temperament, you know, now I'm really able to dial in what I want for my program. So Killian is 15 months. Last time I weighed him, he was 110 pounds. His height to his withers, I believe, was 25. So he's a good sized boy. Honestly, I love that dog's temperament and his working ability. He's so much fun, so much fun. I love a dog that's like, let's do it, let's work. Because you can do so much with that attitude that Killian has right there. That being said, me working him, of course, in the confirmation ring, he did a wonderful job. We competed at the ABA, the American Bulldog Association, their nationals out in Las Vegas, and he did really well. I'm hoping to kind of progress through the rings with him a little bit, the confirmation rings. But after that, I'm gonna probably start pushing him more towards the protection work and seeing if we can get a little more work out of him because he honestly does love it. So I would love to push him towards what he wants to do. I'm just hoping to maybe get a title on him before we do that. So Kimber's probably a fan favorite. I have more people hitting me up asking me about Kimber than any dog on my property. She's absolutely gorgeous. She was probably the first female that I ever kept from any of my breedings that I just fell in love with head over heels. Her bone is incredible. It's honestly as thick as most males in the breed, which is stunning right when you see her. People usually think she is a stud when she walks in. And again, that stable temperament. I've never had an issue with her. Ira is an absolute fireball. I mean, she's hard to hold still. I would have loved to take her to the show, but she's just too much, man. She's too much. As far as impressive, she's just gorgeous, drop-dead gorgeous. She's muscled up. She has crazy definition. And the power behind that little female is just unbelievable. Her high, high drive and her breathing and her movement is just something to really sit back and go awe over. So Gamora's 9 months old right now. So she's a up-and-coming female, still evaluating, of course. But so far, the way Gamora is shaping up, I'm really liking her. She's very, very athletic. She's beautifully structured. I think she has more stifle angle on her than most standard American Bulldogs I see, which is crazy. I don't think I've ever seen a bully with that much stifle. And I'm really, really hoping that she makes it in this program with how gorgeous she is. I originally bred that litter for structure and pigment and somehow knocked it out of the park perfectly. Every single dog came out structured amazing. Everyone, the day they were born, had perfect pigment. Mouth, nose, eyes, everything full. So right away I was blown away and I was ecstatic over the litter. And she really stood out to me. She was probably the bullier of the pups. Even though she's not extremely bully like some of my dogs, she is slightly bully. But that dog is, again, right where I want to be. Insane performance on her and still has those gorgeous looks. For Hale, I'd have to say that I got him actually to bring in a little more size and a little more of that bully aspect into my program. He's a beautifully built stud. We were talking about stifle angle. He's got so much turn of stifle, so much leg underneath him. For a big white set male, he's got a ton of leg underneath him. Absolutely love that. He also has big, thick bone and a lot of muscle, but he's lean, you know, he's lean. And for a big boy, he moves this whole yard. He moves, man. And he's also, again, naturally protective. He watches over this place like a hawk. So Hale's my good old boy. That's for sure. He's my good old boy. Well, I'm Darren from Dax American Bulldogs, and I want to say thank you to you for giving me time to check out all my dogs, hear a little bit about my background and story. And I want to say a big thank you to Dogumentary TV for hitting me up and coming out and, of course, taking some time out of his busy schedule to check out all the dogs as well.